Dr. Hassan Sadri, ophthalmologist with Visionary Eye Institute from Newport Beach, California, coming to you live, excited, at OIS-AAO 2019 here at San Francisco. I'm really excited about my next guest, Patrick De Haas, who is all the way from Belgium. He's a little jet-lagged here with Oxurion. How you doing, Patrick?
I'm good, despite the jet lag. Thank you.
Yes, no, you look pretty good.
Thank you.
A lot of coffee on board.
Absolutely.
Good. Well, welcome to San Francisco, California. Tell us a little bit about yourself and your background so for our viewers can hear and our listeners can learn about yourself.
Okay. Well, I got my medical degree a few years ago at Leuven University. That's in Belgium. And I actually got involved in the industry by accident because I was supposed to do internal medicine, but got a part-time job that was then called Sandoz, now Novartis, and the rest is history.
That's terrific. So that kind of sparked as a young clinician, sort of wanted to get in industry. Is that what happened to kind of spark that interest for you?
Well, I was actually offered a position in Basel, Switzerland in those days. So moved with the family over there and started in the clinical department. And then slowly I moved from clinical to kind of, marketing where the big money was, and then actually became CEO of a medical device company in Minnesota, Minneapolis.
Ah, very good.
Involved in insulin therapy. So we brought the first watertight insulin pump to the US market.
Terrific. That's a terrific journey. So tell us a little bit about your role now and what you're excited about. So your preclinical and clinical developments with Oxurion. Yeah. Tell us a little bit about that.
So Oxurion, the first molecule we developed from the bench all the way to the market, Oxyplasmin Jetrea. That was our first molecule. But let's say 5 years ago, we started focusing on diabetic eye disease and set up the relevant preclinical models. And actually currently have three molecules in the clinic. And we have readouts. We had two already and one more readout by the end of the year. So where the preclinical department is actually currently focusing on dry AMD, our clinical group is now focusing on those three assets in DME.
So when you say that to the audience, kind of clarify for me. From the bench, that means you brought it in-house, developed it yourself, and went through the different stages? Or do you ever look at outside to acquire any assets?
So we do both, actually. Jetrea was something that basically, we were a spin-off from the University of Leuven. So that was at the benches, as such. The antiplacental growth factor as well, that is based on research of Peter Carmelit,
yes.
Who is rather famous for his anti-PLGF work. And then the two other assets we licensed in.
I see. So that's interesting. You said you decided basically to license two based on, tell us through that. What makes a company decide to go and license, so for audience to understand versus not license?
Well, many companies have a technology platform, like certain antibodies, but then you're kind of bound to that platform. And what we have found is that not all targets can be dealt with by the same technology. So from the very beginning, we focused on the disease, back of the eye disease, but technology independent. When our scientists identify an interesting target, then we go and look for the technology. Mm-hmm. And that's why in the portfolio we have small molecules, we have peptides, and we have full-size antibodies, because we want to be technology independent.
Excellent. And then, so when you're, tell us a little bit about sort of how your model fits into OIS, coming today and meeting you. Tell us how OIS can help with your vision, and also what do you get out of OIS? How does OIS help you?
Well, OIS is for us an extremely important meeting because it's not just the KOLs that are here, but especially most companies are represented here. So you basically, we give a presentation and 50 other companies give a presentation, but the main thing is that as many meetings around OIS. So it's a perfect gathering place for ophthalmology.
Very good, yeah. And I think for those of this in audiences who haven't been to OIS, I'd really encourage you to look the meetings up at AAO, ASCRS, and now most recently with optometry. It's integrating companies with KOLs and others. Let's kind of go back. If I'm a young internist entrepreneur and I'm really interested in industry, give us some advice to our audience members who are kind of looking back. You look back in your career, give them some pearls. What are your thoughts? Give us some feedback on mentorship, if you will.
Well, I think the first thing is always know your business very well. You have to really understand the business in and out. That's the very basis. So if you want to talk to investors, these guys are very savvy, and they are also supported by very savvy, you know, other people. So know your business in and out. That's already, you know, a big thing. The second thing is that, you know, for young physicians that want to join the industry, you need to have a certain passion for people as well. You know, just being a nerd doesn't cut it.
Good point.
You really
that
need...
That should be a license plate.
Yeah. It's taken. No. But it's like you really have to build a team. Mm-hmm. Because, you know, alone you can go fast, but in team you go longer, you go further.
Yes, very famous saying. It's true. So did you train to do that? Are you doing that now? Are you mentoring other people in your company now and outside the company? How did you learn how to become a good leader? That's another good question I think people want to know.
Well, you know, I basically was treating patients for a few years, and the interaction with patients is an extremely important basis to get to deal with other people. You know, it's like, so if you're good with patients, you're good with people, and the money will come.
Yeah. I agree. And even in our practices, you take care of everybody like your own family, and that just organically grows your practice.
Right.
And industry, same thing. People just want to feel appreciated, I think, and input to be instilled and be a part of something. Would you
Absolutely.
Agree with that? Yeah. So going back to Auxurion, tell me, are you just going to be focused on the back of the eye? Are you going to be doing full spectrum at some point? What about other areas that you're looking at? Some exciting areas in 2020 and beyond.
Well, we have two companies, actually. We have Auxurion, which is focused on the back of the eye. And again, there we do DME clinically. And currently, we have some assets in dry AMD. But we also have a company called Oncurious. And that's a joint venture with the Flemish Institute of Biotechnology. We have 85% of the equity. They have 15% of the equity. And there we develop second-generation immuno-oncology assets. But it's a completely separate company.
In ophthalmics?
No.
Systemic.
This is systemic oncology.
Gotcha. Very good. Interesting.
Because we think that, you know, you have to be extremely specialized in what you do. So we only do back of the eye in one company, and we only do immuno-oncology in the other one.
Do you have two sets of staff then? Let's take through that. Do you have a set of BD for both companies? Do you share? How does that work?
The way it works, the experts, the scientific experts, they are separate in the two companies, but the services, finance, HR, what have you, is joined.
It's smart. Shared, So if you, I don't know if you picked that up, that was really smart. So what he's doing is that clinical expertise is focused, because that's what they're good at, and laser focused on the back of the eye and oncology or immunology. But then the other services are shared, so that creates a lower cost for both entities. Smart.
Correct.
Very good. Are there any things you're excited about seeing here today that you're meetings, any excited meetings that you're meeting with today? Any startups or any other?
Well, there are clearly, you know, many interesting startups that we have seen.
Any favorites, anything you like, you want to share with?
Well, you know, one thing that I like is those eye drops, you know. Those sprays that replace eye drops, it's you know, if people can find good ways of getting eye drops delivered, I think that's very practical.
Yeah, compliance is a big problem. Absolutely. Absolutely. I had a patient of mine, we just saw it, into your point, high pressure is when to take her drops. And she says, I swear I'm taking my drops, doctor. I said, show me how you're doing your drops. She would just open her mouth. Okay. I kid you not. Yeah. There's these assumptions that we have as doctors.
Now, is this California?
Yes, it is. Southern Cal. Too much sunlight. It was a pleasure meeting you, Patrick.
My pleasure.
I wish you all the best.
Thank you.